So what happens if we decide to have surgery? Well, typically we will have a meeting with the family, so we get to know each other, answer questions. We talk about the attendant risks of surgery. Every surgery has some risk, and while those risks are very low, they're not zero. The scariest risk is the risk of causing a stroke during the surgery. The reason is if the blood vessels are narrow and unhealthy and the child goes through the stress of a surgery, going to sleep, anesthesia, surgical manipulation, you run the risk of a stroke. While every child can get their number sort of tailored specifically, by and large, that number is somewhere around 3 to 5%. So it's very, very low. 95 to 98% of the time, the kids do fine, but it's not zero. On the other hand, that risk is offset by the benefit of hopefully providing them with some great lifelong protection from stroke. So those are the risks. We'll often have the child come in the day before surgery, and the reason is to reduce the risk of surgery, we give them IV fluids overnight so they're not dehydrated, their blood pressure is high, and the parents can stay right by their bedside the whole time. In the morning, I see the patient or my colleagues see the patient, and whoever the surgeon is the boss. So you're there the whole time from start to finish. And one innovation we have at Children's is if the child has moyamoya on both sides of the brain, which is very common in about 2/3 of cases, if necessary, we can do both sides under a single anesthesia, which markedly reduces the risk. And this is a real innovation we've done for over 15 years here at Boston Children's and really seems to work well. The surgery is pretty short. It's about 2 hours a side. We make an incision usually along here, sort of from the sideburn up to almost the top of the head. And then the children go to the intensive care unit afterwards. They're awake, talking, doing everything normally. Usually it's a day or so in the intensive care unit. Again, a family member can stay right by their side. And then usually 3 to 5 days in the hospital. They can fly home pretty much anytime, but we often recommend if they're from far away to spend a day or two in Boston outside of the hospital before they fly home. So all told, you're about a week in the city, give or take. So that's just a general overview of what the surgery timeline is like, what the risks are, and a little bit of what the hospital stay is like in terms of family and the patient themselves. And so hopefully that helps to remove some of the mystery about treatment for kids while they're in the hospital.